are you, sir?
I'm good, and you?
I'm fine, thank you. Sir, are you speaking to Nosbele? I'm coming from Railway Safety Regulator. I wish to know, how long have you been here?
I've been here for the past 3 years.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So you've been observing the incidents that are happening here?
Yes, lots of them.
Is it?
Yeah.
So what is your concern about the pedestrians here and your motorists? What is your concern as a person who's working here on day-to-day basis?
Yeah, my concern about the pedestrians is that they too much ignorant. They don't adhere to the safety rules and the regulations of the rail. And even if you try to explain to them what they must do, they will tell you to mind your own business. And they do their own thing. And they don't even care about what's going to happen because they will say their safety is their own priority. So you don't have to tell them about anything. But concerning the motorists here, yeah, they use a lot of speed and they don't even adhere to the road signs, stop signs. People want to try to show them that they must stop before they cross the railway line, they will tell you about the time. And most of the time, most of the people, they're always late. No one is on time, no one is concerned about safety. They only concerned about where they go. That's when most of the accidents occurs. Because when they find out that they're late to cross the railway, it's when the train is closer and he stops. He doesn't even measure the distance where he's supposed to stop. And that's why he gets hit by the train. Most of the accidents that I've seen here, they stop very close to the railway line. That's when the train comes and pushes them away. Because if you stop on the railway line, it means you're on the space for the train. So they stop there, the train comes and it pushes them away. That's how the incident happens here.
Okay, tell me, with the taxi drivers that you have here in the ring, what do you do? Do they comply? If they do, what do you do if they don't?
Most of our drivers, 99% of them, they comply. And those who don't comply, we take them to DC and we give them a very heavy discipline fine. Sometimes we let them stay home for 3 months, or we chase them away at all from around the rank because they don't adhere to the rules. Even those who are stubborn, we remove them here. We want people who can comply with the law and who can work together with PRAS.
Okay, tell me, last question. What's this Taxi Association, it's under which association, this taxi rank?
This taxi rank is under both Mata and Malta associations. Okay. Both associations that are running Mamelodi.
Okay.
We did a combine from both associations.
Okay.
So everything that we do here, we report on both offices. And they come in here to come and check on us, give us advices, and they help us a lot where they can. They even recognize us as a rank, and everything we do through the office.
Okay, thank you.